Hi, I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company, and welcome to our upcoming November 30th, December 1st and 2nd premier firearm sale, our last sale of 2018. Extremely excited to welcome you here. We have a wonderful auction. We've had a great year in 2018. We're going to end it just as strong. From Colts, Winchesters, Marlins, Savages, Class 3 items, U.S. military, fine sporting guns, we have it all. Known collections, how about the Robert M. Lee collection, the Alan Coors collection, the Robert Peterson collection, the Al Mackey collection, the Larry Jones collection. The list is as endless as the guns. But without further ado, I want to talk to you about three important factory engraved Colts. I've been lucky enough to be able to observe, handle, research, study some of the finest percussion Colts known. And that's really thanks to the Robert M. Lee collection. We've got to see some wonderful, wonderful stuff. And when you're talking about the difference between good and great, when you talk about guns as a vehicle of investment, of an investment class asset, or if you desire to own the very best, you have to know the difference and what sets something apart and what takes it over that edge to be truly exceptional. And we have that in three different respects here. I'll start here in the middle. And these, you know, you hear about Tiffany Colts, Tiffany Colts, Tiffany Colts, and nine times out of ten, they're not authentic. They aren't. And what happens is just like with Frederick Remington bronzes, they cast an original. They'll use an original grip. They'll cast off it, and they'll make reproductions, a casting of an original. But now what we have here is a Thor conversion Colt 1861 Navy, but it's got a great pedigree. Originally discovered by Robert Abels in 1944, it's documented in both the Colt Book of Engraving and Colt Pistols by Wilson. And the story from Abels was that he procured it from the president of Peru. Whether he did or whether he didn't, this set was discovered in 1944. And when you get the opportunity to look at a Tiffany grip Colt, always do it. Always, always do it, because the devil's in the details. And that's exactly where we're going to start. We're going to start on the grip. And you have to look at the background. First place to look is the background. How does the background look? Are there pits in the background? Is it, when they do these sand castings, they lose the detail. And so you could see it's very well pronounced here in the background. All the details are very well pronounced. And then you go to the very famous battle scene, and how pronounced is it? Can you see the flags? Can you see the faces on the soldiers? I'll flip it around and ask you the same question. But the answer here is unequivocally yes. And that goes back to its pedigree. Designated to be engraved, serial number is 14518. Nimshki engraved, no doubt about it. Gold, silver plated, hand engraved cylinder scene. Thor conversion with an original cylinder, a very handsome case with a silver plated Colt patent flask to match. And again, you have to take the whole set as it is. You can't beat its pedigree. If you want to own a Tiffany Colt, if you desire to own the very rare, highly sought after, beautiful collaboration between Colt and Tiffany, here's your shot. Separating good from great is very important. And when you look at factory engraved percussion Colts, again, I think you have to set the stage. How rare is something? And what a beginning collector and advanced collectors know is that you start walking around a gun show, you start poking around online, you want to target factory engraved percussion Colts, you have to break them down by rarity. And what do I mean by that? Well, you know, there's approximately 350,000 1849 pockets. For 1851 Navies, about 250,000. And so they were the most heavily produced. And so you'll often see those more embellished. You'll see more factory engraved 1849s and 1851s than anything else. Then it'll go 1855s. And so collectors, especially people that want to be at the top end, they want to buy the best of the best, they can hold out. They can wait for a really great 1849 pocket because the averages are in their favor. And these two guns are right at that edge of good and great. And they both have features that I think take them over the top into that realm of investment class, great, not good. And I'll just go, I'll go strictly by manufacture date, because then I think we can compare the two later. But here you have a relatively early gun, approximately 1853, 1854. Again, there's another feature that, kind of ties all these together. But let's start here. Mother of pearl grips, which is extraordinarily rare. But I'm gonna set the gun down. I want to just look at the case, because this is the finest 1849 pocket case I've ever seen. No questions. No, I couldn't tell you what second place is, because nothing else rates. Very famous Kidder case. Kidder patented the reinforced brass edges, which you'll see here. It's also marked with the patent dates. But the floral lining is just absolutely spectacular. So rare. And the condition of it to match sets it apart. Again, a silver-plated Colt patent flask to match. This set has been together since day number one. There's no doubt about it. Nothing's been high-graded. Nothing's been changed. It is as it is, as it was found, as it was sold, as it was purchased. The gun, in and of itself, a spectacular gun. No question, Gustav Jung engraved. And you'll see it more of a deluxe pattern for Mr. Jung, too. But the very famous animal heads, which this gun has three or four of them, but you can see one here on the left-hand side. Hand-cut Colt's patent here on the left side. Beautiful, dark, rich, strong, original case hardening on the frame, on the trigger. I'll flip it up. You'll see a hand-engraved presentation barrel address, Samuel Colt. It's the condition, it's the subtleties that set this thing apart. The cylinder is flaked, totally acceptable. This gun's been in its case for since 1853. The cylinder is flaked, but you can see it's not wear. The cylinder stops are not battered, and you see that high polish on the cylinder. But you know, you can see here on the case where the cylinder sat, that's what happens, the blue flakes, and that's exactly what happened on this gun. Full silver treatment on the grip strap, factory engraved, with the dot as a designation, even engraved here on the muzzle. It's the subtleties here, and so a great package. So this is 1853. And we're pre-Civil War, mother of pearl grips, the finest case. That thing's special. Now we'll go post-Civil War. We're gonna go 1868. And this is a very classic, but rare, because they didn't do it for very long, vine period engraving done by the factory. They call it vine work. But you see the differences in the process itself. You see that the case hardening changed. It's brighter here. It's vivid here. More iridescent as you go 1853. It's more subtle. It's more toned. It's more deep. But you can see the brightness here. And I'll just roll it. And if you're a student of Colt firearms, specifically factory engraved stuff, you'll know what I'm talking about with the vine engraving. If not, it should be immediately apparent. This gun's well known. It's well photographed. It's photographed in the book of Colt firearms. It comes from a very well-known, astute collection and astute collector. And again, when we talked about, okay, 1849s, they might not be as rare as factory engraved, but you can see these things are special for their condition, for the rarity of the vine leaf, for the rarity of the condition. Again, the condition, the mother of pearl grips, and the beautiful deluxe burl grips. And so all these guns have special grips, absolutely special grips, which I think is cool. It ties them all together. But if you've been waiting, if you've been looking to procure that 49 for your collection, that Tiffany grip Colt, here's your opportunity. And I don't think they do not compete. They're different. And if you study Colts, if you collect factory engraved Colts, then it's all about the subtleties. And here they are. And these are really only the beginning. The fabulous Patterson out of the Lee collection, the best second model Dragoon, and that's just the percussion Colts. We're not talking cartridge Colts or Winchesters or Savages or U.S. military or sporting guns. This December sale is going to be electric. So if you've ever considered coming to one of our sales, why not now? Why not now? Mark it in your calendars, November 30th. December 1st and 2nd. Don't forget about our preview day, November 29th. Live public preview, open to the public. At night, we do a party. We make it fun. We make it enjoyable. So come see us. For more information, visit our website, www.rockallenauction.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Can't encourage you enough to come in December. Hope to see you then.